said something, and you forgot that you did.
What's wrong with you? That's impossible.
Well, but don't ask me. This is all your fault. When it comes to Julio, you are a complete idiot.
I'm an idiot. How can you even say that? You know me better than that. I'll think of Celine before anyone else. But what do I do if Julio does know the truth?
So, that would be the only way to test your friendship. Because if Julio really is a friend, he will not get you into trouble.
How can you expect him not to? You think he'd value a friend more than he would value a wife?
If that's so, you'd better start praying that in this situation, he'll value your friendship more.
I've checked the length of time Mio Buenaventura was in prison, and it doesn't add up to Celine's age now. I also asked some of Mio's old friends. He and Teresa have been separated for a long time. If that's so, Celine is not his child. I really don't think so, but I will still look into it, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Celine. Oh, Margot. So, are you ready for the big dinner?
I'm not sure if I am. I'm worried about the whole thing. You know I'm not good at pretending.
If you'd ask me to describe her, she's one of the people I consider a real saint. She's one of a kind. She's the perfect mother and the perfect wife. That's why when the thing with Ethan's dad happened, it devastated her completely. Because her whole life revolved around her family. She's been through a lot. I feel bad for Ethan's mom. I'm glad she's so much better. That's right. I wonder if she'll like me. I'm not Ethan's girlfriend. It's you. Wait a minute. Let me get my stuff ready, okay? I'm almost done for the day. All right. Thanks a lot. You want to look at the others?
No, I'm fine.
Hi. How much for the slippers?
Hi.
The slippers? I can give you 2 pairs for 80.
Okay, I want this
pair. All right. Good choice. Here you go, miss.
Oh, thank you. Here's your slippers.
Thank you. Don't forget your change. I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Okay, here you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Review for the exam.
Okay, I'll ask Aaliyah to bring snacks to your room. Go ahead, you can study now. And if you need anything, just let me know. As long as you pass this exam. Okay? Yes,
information. So now we're going to choose the perfect outfit for your big dinner.
But Margot, we're not done studying yet.
Celine, look, I think this would be great on you. And you can wear it with this. Try it on. Hurry.
This dress? I don't think I should. I'm always borrowing your clothes.
Don't worry about it. I wonder what Aunt Martina's preparing for dinner. Go on, Celine, try that on.
All right.
Hello, Ethan.
Where do you go?
wear to the dinner with your family.
You sure you want to push through with it?
Of course I am. The whole thing is my plan, remember?
I'm sure about this.
Your mom is going to love Celine.
I guess so. If Celine wins mom over with her sense of humor,
but I would give
anything in the world to introduce you as my girlfriend.
I want that too.
But I know that
there is a right time for that, Ethan.
Everything okay?
Yes, we're fine, ma'am. Margot and I decided to take a break. I just went out for some.
Why don't you have dinner here?
What? Okay, all right, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Celine, I know we've had our differences in the past, but I've come to realize that my daughter needs you. She needs to pass the subject, so please help her.
I always try to help Margot in any way I can.
Thanks, Celine. You know, I really don't understand what's been bothering Margot lately. But ever since, she's so easily distracted from her studies. She's not like you. You're determined to succeed.
Well, honestly, Margot also wants to pursue her goals.
I know. But she always needs someone to push her to succeed. I am sure you have noticed how hands-on I am with my daughter.
Celine and Margot are the same age, so if you really think about it, the child Teresa had as her surrogate would have been the same age as Celine now.
Julio, that is purely a coincidence.
Yes, I know. That's why we need to find concrete evidence that can prove that Celine is my daughter.
You want concrete evidence?
Yeah.
A DNA test. If your DNA and Beatrice matches that of Celine's, well then, she's your daughter. But the only problem that I see is how you're going to convince Teresa to let Celine take a DNA test.
What samples do we need?
There's blood, saliva, and even hair or nail samples. But that's more uncommon.
Yolanda, I found out something interesting.
What is it?
Why are you investigating me?
How did you find out?
Does it matter? Why are you doing this to me? I'm your husband, Yolanda.
Lucas, I'm sorry. You can't blame me. After everything I saw in you, and after your last detective...
Do not insult me, Yolanda. I'm your husband.
I'm really so confused, Lucas. I was desperate. I just want to find out the truth. Uncle, let me...
Oscar!
Hey!
You two hurry up. Pack all of our things because we're moving out tonight.
So we're going to move again?
Yes, we are. Have you two forgotten? Julio knows where we live, remember? And now we have the chance to leave this place for good, so Julio can never find us.
That's right. But wait, how are we supposed to do that? We don't even have money.
Didn't you hear what I said? I already have money. You won't believe what happened today, Dad. One of my customers was a woman who left her wallet at my store.
And you didn't return it?
Am I done talking?
Well, anyway,
I got the wallet and I looked all over for her. I found her and returned her wallet. She was so happy.
So you don't have money at all?
No, she gave me a reward for returning her wallet. Oh, get going. Hurry up, Dad. We have to pack.
To be more careful from now on. Yolanda is not stupid, and I gave her a reason for her to doubt me. From now on, I have to make sure that I don't get caught, because when that happens, I know I will lose her forever. Well, we can just pack up our things and leave just like that, Teresa. Look, Celine's been asking a lot of questions. This will make her even more suspicious.
Wait, please.
What?
Well, nothing's going to my head anymore. It's just too much information. So now we're going to choose the perfect outfit for your big dinner. But Margot, we're not done studying yet. Celine, look, I think this would be great on you. And you can wear it with this. Try it on.
Wait, this dress? I don't think I should. I'm always borrowing your clothes.
Don't worry about it. I wonder what Aunt Martina's preparing for dinner. Go on, Celine, try that on.
All right.
Hello, Ethan?
What are you guys doing?
Well, Celine and I are picking out what she'll wear to the dinner with your family.
You sure you want to push through with it?
Of course I am. The whole thing is my plan, remember?
I'm sure about this, Ethan.
Your mom is going to love Celine.
I guess so.
If Celine wins mom over with her sense of humor,
but I would give
anything in the world to introduce you as my girlfriend.
I want that too.
But I know that
there is a right time for that, Ethan.
Everything okay? Yes, we're fine, ma'am. Margot and I decided to take a break.
I just went out for some.
Why don't you have dinner here?
What? Okay, all right, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Celine, I know we've had our differences in the past, but I've come to realize that my daughter needs you. She needs to pass the subject, so please help her.
I always try to help Margot in any way I can.
Thanks, Celine. You know, I really don't understand what's been bothering Margot lately. But ever since, she's so easily distracted from her studies. She's not like you. You're determined to succeed.
Well, honestly, Margot also wants to pursue her goals.
I know. But she always needs someone to push her to succeed. I am sure you have noticed how hands-on I am with my daughter.
Celine and Margot are the same age, so if you really think about it, the child Teresa had as her surrogate would have been the same age as Celine now.
Julio, that is purely a coincidence.
Yes, I know. That's why we need to find concrete evidence that can prove that Celine is my daughter.
You want concrete evidence?
Yeah.
A DNA test. If your DNA and Beatrice matches that of Celine's, well then, she's your daughter. But the only problem that I see is how you're going to convince Teresa to let Celine take a DNA test.
What samples do we need?
There's blood, saliva, and even hair or nail samples. But that's more uncommon.
Yolanda, I found out something interesting.
What is it?
Why are you investigating me?
How did you find out?
Does it matter? Why are you doing this to me? I'm your husband, Yolanda.
Lucas, I'm sorry. You can't blame me. After everything I saw in you, and after your last detective...
Do not insult me, Yolanda. I'm your husband.
I'm really so confused, Lucas. I was desperate. I just want to find out the truth. Uncle, let me...
Oscar!
Hey!
You two hurry up. Pack all of our things, because we're moving out tonight.
So we're going to move again?
Yes, we are. Have you two forgotten? Julio knows where we live, remember? And now we have the chance to leave this place for good, so Julio can never find us.
That's right. But wait, how are we supposed to do that? We don't even have money.
Didn't you hear what I said? I already have money. You won't believe what happened today, Dad. One of my customers was a woman who left her wallet at my store.
And you didn't return it?
Am I done talking?
Well, anyway,
I got the wallet and I looked all over for her. I found her and returned her wallet. She was so happy.
So you don't know money at all?
No, she gave me a reward for returning her wallet. Oh, get going. Hurry up, Dad. We have to pack.
To be more careful from now on. Yolanda is not stupid, and I gave her a reason for her to doubt me. From now on, I have to make sure that I don't get caught, because when that happens, I know I will lose her forever. Well, we can just pack up our things and leave just like that, Teresa. Look, Celine's been asking a lot of questions. This will make her even more suspicious.
I don't care.